गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू हैव आवर अनदर लेक्चर ऑफ थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन एंड टुडेज टॉपिक विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज क्लच. दैट मीन्स टुडे वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज क्लच, व्हाट आर द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ क्लच, व्हाट आर द पर्पसेस ऑफ क्लच एंड व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ क्लच. सो लेट स्टार्ट विद द डेफिनेशन. व्हाट इज क्लच? सो अ क्लच इज अ मैकेनिकल डिवाइस दैट इंगेजेस और डिसंगेजेस द पावर ट्रांसमिशन स्पेशली फ्रॉम ड्राइविंग शाफ्ट टू ड्राइविंग शाफ्ट. मेनली अब क्लच क्या होता है? एक मैकेनिकल डिवाइस. इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ मैकेनिकल डिवाइस विच मेनली इंगेजेस और डिसंगेज द पावर ट्रांसमिशन. सो क्लच मेनली कनेक्ट्स और डिसकनेक्ट्स अ पोर्शन ऑफ द अरेंजमेंट विच मेनली ब्लॉक्स द एरिया और समटाइम्स इट अलाउज द एरिया. मेनली क्लच इज पार्ट ऑफ आईसी इंजन और अ मशीन विच मेनली हेल्प्स और ब्लॉक्स फॉर द पावर ट्रांसमिशन. सो लेट अस सपोज टेक एन एग्जाम्पल. व्हेन वी राइड बाइक, सो व्हाइल राइडिंग बाइक व्हेन वी प्रेस द क्लच, दैट सिचुएशन इज नोन एज डिसंगेजमेंट ऑफ क्लच. एंड व्हाइल वी रिलीज द क्लच, दैट सिचुएशन इज नोन एज इंगेजमेंट ऑफ क्लच. सो while we engage the clutch, while engaging the clutch, that means when it is in free state, then it can easily transmit the power from flywheel to the gearbox. But when we disengage the clutch, that means when we put the clutch, where we press the clutch pedal or clutch handle, at that point of time, then there is a restriction of power transmission from flywheel to gearbox. That times clutch plate comes in contact with the flywheel and it restricts the power transmission and it constricts into itself. Then when he again release the clutch, that time again clutch comes into engage position and it completely flows the power transmitter into the gearbox. So in simpler words, I can define that clutch as a mechanical device that is being used for the engagement and disengagement of during the power transmission. So what are the purposes of clutch now? The purposes of clutch is allow the vehicle to come to a stop while transmission remains in gear. That means when we have put gear in third gear or fourth gear or second gear, when that the vehicle is in some gear, that time the clutch is used to help to slow down the vehicle or completely stop the vehicle. So if you have to put the vehicle in gear, in some sort of gear like first, second, third, anyway, at that point of time, if we want to stop the vehicle or slow down the vehicle, at that point of time, clutch is being used. Allow the driver to smoothly take off from a dead stop. That means when we have riding bike, so when riding bike or car, anything, so let us suppose we have to take a sharp turn. At that point of time, we normally either low down the gear or we press the clutch and easily turn the vehicle. That time when we press the clutch, that time power transmission is blocked and we can easily turn the vehicle without any accident or without any machine failure. The third point is allow the driver to smoothly change gears. It allows the driver to smoothly change gears. That means if we will change gear without engaging, without pressing the clutch pedal, at that point of time, since the gears are having a number of teeth, so the teeth will come in contact with each other and it can break each other teeth. So rather there can be produced a large or a noisy sound or anything. So it simply helps the gear teeth to be for to any machine failure or anything, I can say. So ultimately it allows the driver to smoothly change the gear while engaging the or disengaging the clutch pedal. The fourth one is must be able to transmit power and torque without slipping. So it also allows the driver to transmit power and torque without any slipping or without any failure. So these are the mainly four purposes which is being done by or which is being done by a clutch. So now coming back to the principle, what are the principle of clutch? So the principle, that means it operates on principle of friction. Obviously, as it comes in contact with each other and then it operates, so obviously friction will occur. So it operates on principle of friction. when two surfaces are brought in contact and are held against each other due to friction between them, they can be used to transmit power. And it is also being used to transmit power by coming in contact with each other. The third one is, then one is rotated, then other also rotates. One surface is connected to engine, other to the transmission of automobile. That means I am here saying that this is the clutch, this is the flywheel, and this is the gearbox. So, it clutch is a passage or a linking element between this flywheel and gearbox. It simply takes the power from flywheel and transmits it to the gearbox. So it is a linking element between the flywheel and gearbox. It simply takes power from one and transmits it to the other. So now coming to the main parts of clutch. What are the main parts of clutch? So the parts of clutch are, one is driving member, another is driving member, another one is operating member. That means one is driving one, that means at which part we are giving the power, driving member. That means the part which is being driven by the driving member, and the operating member which is being operated by these two members. So these are the mainly three members of a clutch. Now coming back to the classification part, what are the types of clutch? So clutch is mainly classified into two types, that is positive clutch and one is friction clutch. Now friction clutch is also classified into three types, that is plate or disc clutch, cone clutch, and one is centrifugal clutch. So clutch is, and the plate or disc clutch is also classified into again two types, that is single plate clutch and multi-plate clutch. So mainly clutch is classified into two types, that one positive and friction. Friction is classified into three types, plate or disc, cone, and centrifugal. And plate or disc is classified into two types, that is single and multiple. So let's start with plate or disc clutch, and starting with the single plate clutch. So this is the general overview of a single plate clutch. You can see that there is a spring which is being used to for the clutch to come in contact with the flywheel, again get back to its initial position. This is the pressure plate, which is the initial plate of a clutch plate. This is the input shaft, that means here power is being being given, and this is the output shaft from where the power is being transmitted to the gearbox. That means flywheel is giving power here, and clutch is giving power from here to the gearbox. These are the cover, splined, friction lining. This is the flywheel, as I have already said, this is the flying. So these are the overall outer barrier or casing of the clutch plate. So these are the overall casing. These are the springs. This is the pressure plate, which normally comes in contact with the flywheel and absorbs the power from that and transmits it to the output shaft to the gearbox. So let's start with the dictatory part of this single plate clutch. A disc clutch consists of a clutch plate which is free to slide axially on spline cuts on driven shaft. That means disc plate which is being inputted in the single plate clutch is free to move axially on the spline driven shaft. The next point is, spring loaded presses the clutch plate firmly against the flywheel when clutch is engaged position. The spring which is being mentioned here presses the clutch plate firmly. That means it presses the clutch plate against the flywheel when clutch in engaged position. That means when clutch is in engaged position, it completely presses the pressure plate to the flywheel. When the clutch is disengaged, that means when the clutch is released from the engaged position and it is in disengaged position, the spring presses against a cover attached to flywheel, thus both flywheel and pressure plate rotate with input shaft. That means when the clutch converts to disengaged position, the spring presses it against the cover which is being attached to the flywheel. This is the cover. So here it is being attached to the flywheel and it presses it towards the flywheel. And thus both flywheel and pressure plate rotate with input shaft. That means the power being absorbed by the flywheel comes in contact with the pressure plate, and it ultimately start rotating the pressure plate too by the rotation of flywheel. That means let us suppose we have two rotating members. One member is rotating and another remains stationary. If we put the another stationary member in contact with that rotation member, then both will move in same direction. Similar case is observing here also. That means the flywheel is rotating, the pressure plate is being taken near the or taken in contact with the flywheel. Since flywheel is rotating, then the pressure plate will also start rotating. Figure shows the pressure plate pulled back by release levers and friction lining on clutch pit are no longer contact with the pressure plate or flywheel. That means when the clutch again come in engaged position, that at that point of time the pressure plate releases its contact with the flywheel and come back to its initial position and transmits the power to the output shaft through the output shaft to the gearbox. Thus flywheel rotates with driving clutch plate and driving shaft. That means in simpler words, if I can define you what is a single plate clutch, then a simple phenomenon is that when the clutch is in this engaged position, at that point of time clutch is the pressure plate or the spring is contact with the output shaft. But when the clutch comes in disengaged position, at that point of time through the help of a spring, the pressure plate comes in contact with this flywheel. And the since flywheel is moving due to the power produced by the engine, and it also helps the pressure plate to start rotate in the same direction, and hence it transmits the power to the output shaft. I hope this is the general phenomenon of single plate clutch. Now coming back to the multiple plate clutch. Now we are going to study about the multi plate clutch. So in multi plate clutch, the functioning is similar to the single plate clutch. Just there is a difference is that there are number of clutch plates being assigned compared to single plate clutch. That means in single plate clutch we are only a single plate clutch. Here we will have more than one plate clutch. That means that's why I have written here, when a great amount of torque to transmit instead of single plate, number of frictional plates are employed. That means there are more number of friction plates are being employed in multi plate clutch, thus increases the no mating friction surfaces. It is called multi plate clutch. These are used in heavy commercial vehicle, racing cars, motorcycles for transmitting high torque. When there is a requirement of high torque, at that time point of time multi-plate clutch is being used. Disc plates are free to slide on the spline or drivers and rotates with it. That means the scenarios of multi-plate clutch is similar to the single plate clutch. This is the engine shaft, this is the output shaft, these are the springs, these are the number of friction ring and friction lining, these are the number of disc plates, this is the flywheel. That means, as I have discussed to you, that the procedure or the phenomenon of single plate clutch, the phenomenon or the mechanism of single plate clutch will be similar to that of the mechanism of multi plate clutch will be similar to that of single plate clutch. The whole mechanism part will be similar. There is a simple difference is that in single plate clutch we have having only one plate, one friction plate or one pressure plate or single plate clutch, but in multi plate clutch we are more number of friction plates. And it is being used since we required high amount of torque. Through this we can easily calculate in a single simpler word that if we required a high amount of torque, at that point of time multi plate clutch is being used instead of a single plate clutch. So these are the overall phenomenon of multi plate clutch and single plate clutch. I hope you have understand this. So go through these discussions, and if you have any query then let me know, and in next class we will discuss another type of clutch. Thank you for your attention.